sometimes when you're subtracting numbers, you actually need to borrow from the place value before it. Why is that? And how do we do that? Let's look at a problem right here, and I'll show you what's going on.
We're gonna put the two numbers in our place value chart like we typically do and start in the ones place, 2 minus 5. Wait a minute, I don't have 5 to take away from 2, So what am I going to do? I actually need to borrow from the tens place. So in the tens place is a 4, and we're gonna borrow one group of 10. So that 4 will turn into a 3. We're gonna take that group of 10 and actually add it to the ones place. So instead of 2, it's going to be 12. That looks better, 12 minus 5. I can do that, 12 minus 5 equals 7. Then we'll go to the tens place, 3 minus 2 equals 1. And finally, 8 minus 3 is 5. So our answer is 517. Let's try another one. 5,103 minus 2,046. We're gonna first put this number in a place value chart. I want you to notice something though. What do you think might happen when we borrow? We're gonna have to do something a little different on this problem. All right, we're gonna start in the ones place, 3 minus 6. We can't subtract 6 from 3, so we're going to have to borrow. So just like the problem before, we're gonna go to the tens place. Wait a minute, there's a 0 in the tens place, so we're gonna actually have to borrow from the hundreds place. Watch what I'm doing. I'm actually going to have to borrow from the hundreds place, carry to the tens place, and then carry one more time. All right, we're still not finished because our ultimate goal is we need to borrow to get to the ones place. So we have to borrow 1 from the 10, so that makes it a 9, and we'll add that 10 into the ones place, so 10 plus 3 equals 13. Whew, now we can subtract. 13 minus 6 is 7, 9 minus 4 is 5, 0 minus 0 is 0, and 5 minus 2 is 3. Again, sometimes you actually have to borrow from a few place values in order to get the numbers to subtract. This is something you might have to practice a few times to really get the hang of.
Is there a way that I can check my thinking when I'm finished?
There's actually a great way to check your thinking when using the standard algorithm subtraction. You can take the difference and add it to the subtrahend, and it should equal the top number. So for example, 2 plus 1 equals 3, 3 plus 2 equals 5, 5 plus 1 equals 6. So I know that my difference is correct. Wait a minute, what were all those fancy terms you just used? Quick review, there's 3 main parts to a subtraction problem. A subtrahend, the difference, and a minuend. Look at these right here. The minuend will be the top number, the subtrahend is what you will be subtracting, and the difference is the answer.
Now that we've done a couple together, let's see if you can do a couple subtraction problems on your own.
924 minus 517. Minus 13,421. Remember, you can pause this if you need more time. 15,705.
How'd you do? Did you get them correct? Do you need other videos like this? How to add, or how to multiply, or maybe more about fractions? Make sure you check out our other videos on our channel. Thanks for joining in, and I hope to see you soon.